You can find all kinds of great stuff at a thrift store. Barely worn fashion pieces at a fraction of the cost. Fun little knickknacks from years gone by. I'll never forget the time I was on tour and we stopped in a thrift store and I found an 80s Ultimate Warrior tablecloth that we wound up using for our merch table. Or how about a dead body? That may be the case in a developing story that begins with a Facebook group called Weird Secondhand Finds That Just Need to Be Shared. As the name implies, it's dedicated to all of the weird stuff that people find in thrift shops. Although the group is generally pretty lighthearted, it took a darker turn on April 17th of 2019 when this was posted. Found in and under a drawer of a donated desk. Edit. It was donated to the store I work at a few months ago. Pics were taken, but I don't know if anyone followed through with the report. It was sold later that day. The top of the desk drawer reads, "The truth is under," and underneath it says, "The body lies at," and there's a series of coordinates. Now, anybody can write anything on a piece of furniture. It doesn't necessarily mean that it's true. In fact, when I first saw this thing, it reminded me of an old Easter egg on the Game Boy game Genie, where you put in a button combination and all of a sudden you get the message, "Help, I'm a prisoner in a Game Genie factory." This could very well have been a joke just like that, but let's for a moment entertain it as if it were for real. So the first thing to do is see where these coordinates take us. By checking Google Maps, we can see that it puts us at the side of a road in the middle of the Avon Park bombing range in Highland County, Florida. Property that's owned by the US Air Force. And it's used for, you guessed it, bomb testing. So would that mean that our hypothetical suspect is in the military? Not necessarily. Although military personnel would probably be the most likely suspect, the road might be accessible to the public, and in fact, there is a YouTube video of a guy that claims that he's driving on the road. And even if not, there's still the potential that someone could have broken in. The fact that the desk was donated to a store that's located an hour and a half drive away from this place says that, at the very least, the person was local for some period of time. And although most people at first wrote this off as a joke, especially as soon as people realized that this was in the middle of a bombing range, there were some people who wanted to play amateur detective. Thankfully though, so far nobody has actually went to the spot and tried to dig like this was that episode of The Simpsons. Please don't turn this into the Big T episode of The Simpsons. The detective work on this case was ramped up a notch as a Reddit user named Woodenhead posted this to r/WTF. The post received nearly 30,000 upvotes and hit the Reddit front page, where now thousands of Redditors were in on the investigation. One person claiming to be a local described the location. "I own recreational property just north of that location." As someone else mentioned, the pinned location is inside the Avon Park bombing range, or MacDill AFB Auxiliary Field as it is officially known. If you zoom out a little bit and look north, you will see River Ranch Property Owners Association and our campsites and the fence line that separates the RRPOA and the range. We ride our four-wheelers down to the very southeast end of the property and watch them do bombing runs. Aside from trespassing on a military installation, you do not want to go trekking out there. Lots of unexploded ordnance. The base does issue permits to hunt on the base, but it's not anywhere near where the pin location is. Another Redditor claiming to be a fighter pilot who was located at this base described how the base works. Fighter pilot here. Yeah, that's a live range. There are going to be range controllers in and around that area anytime the range is cold. The giant circle is a nuke circle that we used, and still occasionally use, to practice tossing a nuke into. No shit. The other ones that look like tracks going into a target are strafe, gun, pits, and the ones that look like circles are traditional targets that they can score your bombs. We use these little guys. But some Redditors theorize that this would be the perfect place to leave some evidence. Wouldn't that be a good place to ditch some evidence? Sounds to me more like a joke. Some guy thought it'd be funny to give a location of somewhere clearly inaccessible and extremely unlikely to be used to hide any bodies. If this is a real murderer, he's got gigantic fucking balls to bury the body inside a military installation. Not really. Local law enforcement wouldn't want to step in any toes and would be hesitant to search unless they were absolutely sure, versus public land where anybody can stumble into anything and the cops don't need a warrant. If the killer worked there, they would have access and it's not like the gate guards would be searching their car. there would be some camera evidence, but when you've been there for some time, you know your way around and where the blind spots are. Besides, the specific location is in a remote part that's probably rarely driven past, if at all. So, you have a quiet place that nobody's going to stumble upon you or the evidence, where local law enforcement has limited access to, that is surrounded by wildlife that will help destroy evidence. If the body is able to be ID'd, though, the killer better hope there's no obvious motive or connection to them. Because if you work in a military base and your girlfriend's body turns up there, you better believe you're fucked. And the Redditors also found a list of unsolved missing persons cases. It was on the Highland County Sheriff's Office website, and it contained 6 cases of people who have gone missing as recently as 2018 and as far back as 1988. Clearly, this is a situation for the actual police and not internet detectives, but thankfully, people have contacted the authorities. In fact, the Highland County Sheriff's Office has provided an update on the case. We are aware of this post making the rounds. The GPS location is in the middle of the Avon Park bombing range, and the information has been passed along to Air Force officials. This update doesn't provide a ton of information, but thankfully there were some people in the original Facebook group who did manage to get in touch with the police and get a little bit more information. Okay, so I shared this to my personal group, and a friend of mine lives nearish to there, so he called the local cops. Here is my friend's own words. Spoke with a Lieutenant McManus at the Polk County Sheriff's Office, or Highland County, I don't know at the moment, and gave him the relevant info on the image. Apparently their homicide detective had already been contacted by one person earlier, and had brought it up to him, so he was somewhat aware. Since the area is on a military base, it's secure and unable to be really accessed at this time. They're investigating what they can do regarding it, and will, if they have to, wait until tomorrow to check into it. That's all I know. Second update. Just spoke with the homicide detective from Polk County as well. I think it was the homicide detective. He is coordinating with his counterpart at Highland County because apparently it's a rough call for exactly whose jurisdiction it is. In any event, they have to get military authorization to get out there, so it'll be a hot minute. Interestingly, beyond just being procedural red tape, it actually has a purpose. That area is actually a live bombing range, and they need to be sure they won't get blown to hell and back when they do investigate. He will reach back out to me once they have investigated and verified what's up. Once I know what's what, I'll pass that info on to you, and you can get it onto the page later on. And another person claimed to have gotten some more information from the police. It was said that it's believed to be someone that died on the bomb range. Less likely, a waitress that went missing years ago. And note that all of this is just word of mouth and to be taken with a grain of salt. As of now, it's unclear whether or not this case will be perpetually tied up by red tape between the police and the military, and even if they find anything, whether or not the findings will be public, but if you do want to stay updated on this case, go to reddit.com/thebody. And if I find out of any developments, you can be sure that I will let you know on the channel. Anyway, I'd like to thank Wooden Head, who brought this to my attention and who has been leading the investigation on r/thebody. And if you like this video, you should also check out my video about the Reddit mystery hard drive. I'm out of here.